right, ladies and gentlemen, it is time for our penultimate final of this last day of the WDF World Cup here in Esbjerg. It is the women's team final between Wales and the Republic of Ireland. Please welcome first, Rhiann O'Sullivan, Elena Waters-Evans, Eve Watson, Leanne Topper, Team Wales! Ladies and gentlemen, their opponents, Robin Byrne, Caroline Breen, Aoife McCormick, Katie Sheldon, Team Republic of Ireland!
A very warm welcome for the first of the two team finals here at the WDF World Cup in Esbjerg in Denmark. The first final, of course, in the women's competition, and later on it is the men's competition. Now, this team competition is a lot different to most other darting tournaments, and I will try to explain the rules as good as possible. So every team consists of four players each, and then one player by a time will come up on stage and play just one leg. The first team that reaches 9 legs will be crowned the winner. So in theory, what can happen is that all four players play all their four potential matches, and then the score will be 8-8. Then the two teams will have to pick a player to play a last and deciding leg. So it's a very different kind of format, and also a very exciting and interesting one, and also my personal favorite tournament in the whole World Cup. So I hope you are ready for some great entertainment. Now Robin Byrne from Ireland with a very good start to this final. Left 32 just after 15 darts, and here with a chance to bring Ireland in front, 1-0, and that's very much like her. She likes the big celebrations, which the crowd does as well, so great to see passion from the players, and a brilliant start for the Irish team. And as you can see, there's a bit of an error on the screen, as it says that it's first to 9 sets. It is of course first to 9 legs. So I'm sure that our good friends at Dart Connect has it all under control, so you shouldn't be too confused. But going into the final, I think it's fair to say that Wales would be regarded as the favorites. They delivered a superb performance in their semi-final win against England, averaging almost 81, which is a very impressive performance in a team's event, which is often regarded as the hardest format to play at the World Cup. It really is so difficult to walk up on stage, only have your 6 or 3 practice darts, and then it's game on. So credit to the Welsh team, who has done extremely well to get to the final. The same goes, of course, for Ireland, who, after the group stage, has beaten the Netherlands, Australia and Sweden. I think it's fair to say that Rhiannon O'Sullivan is the high profile of the Welsh team, and she is doing really well here. 141 left after 12 darts. Katie Sheldon, a really exciting young player who we all expect some great things from in the future. But this is a brilliant finish by Rhiannon O'Sullivan. A 15 darter and a great ton plus finish. What a great start to this match. Ireland winning the first leg in 18 darts, and then Rhiannon O'Sullivan winning the next one in just 15. So, of course, that means that we can now expect a 12-dart leg followed by a 9-dart leg. That makes perfect sense to me. So, in the first leg that the four players will play up on stage, they will have 6 practice darts, but after the first four legs, they will only, or let me say it in another way, after their first leg up on stage, they will only have 3 practice darts. So, you really need to be able to deliver despite not having the greatest preparation before going up on stage. A great last start here. Great score from Wales. But followed up by Caroline Breen. And this is, of course, a possible checkout. So 2 triple 20s would have left double 19. Now all she cares about is getting as far down as possible. Could use the bullseye here, which she didn't. Now double top for Caroline Breen. And another great leg by both teams. Lana on the 1-3-5. Chose not to start on the bullseye, so I think, to be honest, that was kind of an error. And she is punished in the end. 2-1 for the Irish team after a 19-dart lick. Another really good lick here in the final. After the first 3 legs, the Irish team is averaging 77. This time it's Eve Watson against Iofi McCormack. Eve Watson has been very impressive in the tournament so far. If we have a look down at the overall average list of the team's competitions, she's sat at the 7th highest average of 69. Can't leave a finish, even with three big trebles from 3-4-5. A decent score by McCormack, but when you think about what Watson has produced throughout the tournament so far, you expect that McCormack needs to put in some trebles to really push her Welsh opponent. Should go for the 18s here, which she didn't. A single 20 would not have left a possible checkout, so that was an error. A very good last start there from Watson. And now with a chance to make it 2-all. That leaves 43. Double top. And again, very efficient on the doubles so far in the final. Both teams have been very good on the outer ring. And let's just hope that that continues. So, at this point of the match, it's only three practice starts for each player before it's game on. So, again, this is really tough conditions. Good treble from the 19-year-old Katie Sheldon. Very loose start on the third throw there. She aimed for the ball, of course, to try and leave 170. Another good treble by Leanne Topper. Now Katie Sheldon went down to the 19s to make sure that she is on a finish. She really has a very aggressive throw, Leanne Topper. Now two triple 20s and the bullseye would have been the route for the 170 finish. Instead, it's Leanne Topper who has the chance to make it 3-2 for Wales. This time it's double 8. Oh, that is another loose dart, and that gives Katie the opportunity for this 80 checkout. One dart at double 20. And that's another big roar from the Irish team. Leanne will not be happy about that. She was well in front, but it isn't over until it's over. Very impressive by Katie, who again is only 19 years old, so hasn't tried this too many times before. Great start to this leg by Alana. Robin Byrne, of course, won the first leg of this final. She did so with an 18 dart leg. Robin Byrne has had success on the WDF circuit before, especially as a youth player. I remember back in 2014, she was very dominant in the youth tournaments. She won both the pairs tournament and the singles tournament, and therefore, of course, also the overall Europe Cup gold medal. Both players are on a possible checkout. And options here, two treble 19s would have left double 16. Instead, Alana now on 123. Trying to leave 32, but leaves 82 instead. Now double 7. And that is another great big roar from Robin and from the Irish team. This is a brilliant start to the final by Ireland. I don't think I was the only one who regarded the Welsh team as the favorites, but Ireland really has come out firing in this final. And this is a very important leg already, you feel, for the Welsh team. Twenty-six. as already mentioned before, Rhiannon O'Sullivan is pretty much the high profile on the Welsh team. Looking through her statistics from this tournament alone, she has the second highest overall average in the 100. In the women's teams tournament, an overall average of 79. The only one better was Bo Greaves, who finished on 82. And she is well in front in this leg, despite McCormack having the throw. 70. Should go for the triple 18, leaves 68. And in cruise control here with just 68 left after 12 darts. Another brilliant leg in this final. Double four for the best leg of the final so far. At least it would have been. Rhiannon O'Sullivan with the second 15 dart leg in this final. After two legs, Rhiannon O'Sullivan is averaging 100. Very, very impressive by the Welsh captain. And I've just been corrected by the brilliant people at Dart Connect. Of course, every leg is regarded as a set, since it's a new player walking up on stage every time, so the graphics are totally correct. Just as you expect from the people at Dart Connect, who is, as always, doing a very good job. The same goes for Watson here. A brilliant start to the eighth set of the match, I should say. And I think it's quite easy to see too. Well, a very big difference between the throwing style of these two players. While you can see Watson really has a great follow through, that means that there's a full extension of her arm, which provides a greater consistency in the throw. You can see Caroline Breen. Well, when she throws, it's like she stops the throwing action before extending her arm, and that's just, especially when you're under pressure, can make it very difficult to keep your consistency. Now should go for the 10th, that leaves double top, and in a very good position here, Watson to make it 4-all. So Ireland was in front 4-2, but now it looks like Wales will make it 4-all. Watson needs double 10. And there we go. So this is a chance for Wales to get in front of the match for the first time. Two players throwing their free practice darts are now ready for the ninth leg or set of the match. And whoever goes on to win the tournament will be a new champion in the women's team event. Actually, the team event is quite a new invention in the WDF World Cup system. It was held first back in 2015 when England won the final. 2 years later it was Holland, then England again in 2019, and then of course we had a postponement of the World Cup. So we are now waiting for who will be crowned as the fourth winner of the women's team competition at the WDF World Cup. This is brilliant by McCormack. Just as you thought, Wales was back in the match and back in the driving seat. McCormack fires in a brilliant 180. Now double 18. For a 17 dart leg, this is once again a brilliant performance by Ireland. And a very, very entertaining final so far. And let's see if Rhiannon O'Sullivan can keep up that impressive performance. She has played two legs already and won them both in just 15 darts. In other words, she's right now averaging 100. Despite the difficulty of playing in this team's format where you only have 6 practice darts for your first leg and then 3 practice darts for the rest. A solid turn by O'Sullivan. This really is a key leg for both teams, not just because it's tied and we are a little across the midway of the game, but also it's because of the fact that these are two of the greatest female players, not only in this final but in this World Cup. That's brilliant set up by Robin Byrne, who leaves 36. Now Rhiannon O'Sullivan aiming for the bullseye, of course. Now she can't finish this one off, so Ireland with another chance, this time for a 13 dart leg. Goes across to the double nine.
18.
So despite being well in front, this could well go for Wales once again. No. Just narrowly misses below the double 20. So let's see Robin on double nine again. Nope.
10.
Yeah, she will be very disappointed if she doesn't come out victorious in this leg, Robin. And playing so well in the scoring part of the game, but couldn't finish it off. Instead, it's O'Sullivan who makes it 5-5. And we are back level once again. This really is a great final so far. Just one leg above 24 darts. If you have a look at the averages, you will see Ireland is averaging 66 and Wales 69, but there seems to be a pattern that when the teams doesn't win their legs, they are far behind, and of course that hurts the averages. But if we had an overall average of just the winning legs, I think we would be around a 75, perhaps even 80 average for both teams. This is brilliant so far. Young Katie Sheldon once again proving why she is regarded as
55.
A big talent in Irish darts. A very solid and decent throwing action as well. And in a very good position here to bring the Irish team in front once again. Oh, that's unfortunate. That second dart was definitely in the treble. I don't think she would have gone for the bullseye
60.
On the third dart if it had stayed in. But now it's all about taking this out. 18 for double 16.
18.
She has time on her side.
58.
She will have at least six starts from here still, but only needs one. So the Irish team is in front once again. A very close encounter so far, but we still haven't seen the Welsh team in front. Let's see if Leanne Topper can make it all square once again. Caroline Breen, of course, won her first leg of the match in 19 darts, followed up by losing to Eve Watson.
67.
Leanne Topper lost the opening leg of the match to Robin Byrne, and later on lost once again to Katie Sheldon. So It's very hard to predict the outcome of this one. As it always is when it's only best of one leg, best of 501, everything can happen when it's this short format. Caroline Breen with a very healthy lead here, but a two treble visit would put the antwerper back in the leg. She really does need a treble here, but only 30 scored, so I suspect Breen to well, I would have said get herself in a healthy position, but that wasn't a good visit either, so it's still very close, although she's 154 points ahead. Triple 17, now a single 18 will leave double 20 for a 7-5 lead for the Irish team. This is quite a surprise, to be honest, especially considering the performances of the teams in the two semi-finals, as I alluded to at the start of the match. Wales beat England 9-5 with an overall average of 81. That is by far the highest average in the tournament in a single game. Whereas Ireland averaged 66 in their 9-6 victory against Sweden. 13 yards for the woman of the first. So Robin and the rest of the Irish team are now just two legs away from being crowned as just the third different winner of the team's competition at the WDF World Cup. She really is an incredible player, Robin. I spoke about it before that she proved herself as a great player as a youth in the youth tournaments, and now she's proving it once again. 42. Has of course also won a women's series event in the PDC. Here a great and very much important maximum by Eve Watson. That keeps Watson and the Welsh team very much in this leg. But the question is if she can follow it up. The answer is no. So Robin on 106, triple 17 now, can't finish, and leaves 64. Now double 18 for Watson. That's very fine margins. Great effort. 64. Now double top.
24.
And that's brilliant by Watson. She was far behind in this leg, but a brilliant 180 brought her back, and then she proved to be very, very good on the outer ring. I can't think of a single match here on the stage that hasn't delivered in one way or another. I think the players have done themselves very, very proud, and also their countries, of course. And I get the impression that the audience is very satisfied as well. So far, it's been a joy to watch these players up on stage, and the same goes for this final.
70.
I've said it a few times before, but it really is a tough task to walk up on stage in this team's competition, as Katie Sheldon fires in another 180 in this final.
60.
It is such a tough task to just walk up on this stage, having only three practice starts, and then it's game on. But still, these players are delivering great darts for the audience and for you at home. Leaves double 20 after just 12 darts, Katie Sheldon. Another brilliant leg in this final. I keep saying it, but I'm really impressed by all these eight ladies. They are playing exceptionally well. I fully understand, should she go for it? I mean, that's kind of a tough decision she had to make there, because she could have chosen just to either bust the score or hit a single two to leave double four, but in the end she finishes off the leg and makes it 8-6 for Ireland, and that means there's only one way left for the Welsh team. They have to win the next two legs to get this match into a last leg decider. If they don't, then Ireland will be crowned as the WDF World Cup champions. Caroline Breen must be feeling like a football player who can win the Champions League final on the last penalty. She has the chance to win this final for her country. And so far she's doing very well. And she just keeps hammering in those trebles. Brianna O'Sullivan, the high profile for the Welsh team, is doing her job, playing decent in this leg, but she has to play even better against Caroline Breen, who is playing phenomenal right now. Brilliant last start by Brianna O'Sullivan. Oh, that's a single one. 40. The first error in this leg, really, from Breen. But is she punished? 40. The answer is no. So Breen has a real opportunity now on the 76. A loose single five, 71 left. That leaves 54. All right. 70. I mean, that must be six left. I don't think she meant to do that. That's a treble. Now she needs at least a single 20 to leave the bullseye. A treble will leave double five. The crowd is totally silenced by that dart. And that is millimeters away from being on the right side of the wire. You can see the Irish team in the background, all fired up. But Caroline Breen just misses the double. Again, it's Brianna O'Sullivan here to keep the match and the final alive. And she does it. That was missed match darts by Caroline Breen. She played very well in the scoring phase of the game, but just couldn't finish it off. And then Brianna O'Sullivan showed her experience. Instead, it's now McCormack who has the opportunity to finish off this incredible final. I must say, I am not in favor of any of the teams. I just wish for a brilliant final, and I think that is exactly what we have got so far. But also, I think we it's hard to say that we deserve it, but I really want to see this final go into the last and deciding leg. So I'm sorry, McCormack, but I'm kind of ruling for Leanne Topper here. 43. The stress these players are under is incredible. In her previous three legs, McCormack, she lost the first two, then she won the third one in just 17 darts. She will hope to do something similar here. Leanne Topper is still yet to get on the board. And the players are, of course, very much aware of their opponent's statistics in this match. So McCormack would have thought beforehand that this is a real chance. I can hit the deciding double for my country. But she needs to get down to a double in the first place, and she's doing very good towards that goal. That's another brilliant last start by McCormack, who leaves 36. She will come back for double 18 for the title.
78.
Just look at that Irish team now, double 16. Even I'm nervous at this point. Double 8.
20.
Just misses the deciding double. Yeah, the feelings are very strong on both players, of course. These are very important moments of the match, of the tournament, of the final. McCormack this time, double 8 to be, oh, that is double, one left, and it's in. McCormack finishes off the final. Ireland are World Cup champions 2015. England won the gold medal in 2017. It was the Dutch team who came on top. 2 years later again, it was England who won the gold medals for a second time. Today, it's the Irish team who is crowned the world champions in the teams competition. Robin Byrne, Katie Sheldon, Caroline Green and Aofi McCormack have made the upset. They have defeated that impressive Welsh team by 9-7. A brilliant, brilliant final and a well-deserved win for the Irish team. They played an exceptional match, and I'm feeling so honored and humbled that I that I had the privilege of watching that match right here at the Granley Hockey Arena. That was something special, and we are hopefully going to witness something similar in the next and final of this tournament. We will first have a prize ceremony in the ladies team event, and right after that we will have the men's team competition final. So stay tuned, there's another brilliant final in just a few moments' time between Holland and England. Stay tuned, and we will be back with the prize ceremony and then another